सुरेंद्र सर,
यस सर, गुड आफ्टरनून सर। स्टार्ट
ओके बाय।
कर।
गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ ईश्वर इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज सिविल डिपार्टमेंट, आई वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर दिस वेबिनार सीरीज। आई थैंक अवर मैनेजमेंट, प्रिंसिपल, वाइस प्रिंसिपल फॉर द एनकरेजमेंट एंड मोटिवेशन एंड फॉर द मॉरल सपोर्ट they have given to conduct such seminars, webinars. This lockdown period has facilitated lot of webinars, lot of updation of our knowledge, and this will surely bring a better skills for our faculties, all the civil engineering faculties, I hope. And this contest, this initiation is done by, organized by student chapter of Institution of Engineers of Ishwar Engineering College. I congratulate them for organizing this webinar, which will be very interesting, definitely, because most probably for the civil engineers, that too for a structural engineers, bridge engineering is always a very interesting field. And now I welcome Engineer Samuel sir, Deputy Executive Engineer of Roads and Building Department. Welcome sir, welcome for this webinar. And I welcome all the participants who have eagerly joined to hear about bridge engineering. This will surely update your skills and clear all your doubts. And I now request Chandrakantamma madam to introduce the guest speaker. Please madam.
Okay ma'am, thank you ma'am. Good afternoon, one and all present here. I welcome all the participants for today's webinar. I take immense pleasure to introduce today's guest for the webinar, Engineer L. Samuel, who did his BTech Civil Engineering from NIT Warangal and MTech Structures from NIT Warangal. He is a certified programmer in Java from Kakatiya University. He is a certified data scientist with Python from IIT Madras. At present, he is working as Deputy Executive Engineer in Roads and Buildings Department, Government of Telangana. He started his career as supervisor in AP Housing Corporation. After that, he worked as campus engineer in NIT Warangal for 2 years. He worked as Assistant Executive Engineer and Deputy Executive Engineer for 20 years in execution of buildings, bridges, and roads in PWD. He worked as additional project director under NREDA of the Department of Rural Development, Government of India for 3 years, and he worked in Indira Jalaprabha scheme in Warangal district. He worked as divisional engineer in Telangana Tourism for 2 years, and he executed tourism circuit projects. At present, he is in quality control wing, monitoring quality of the works in 2 districts. He is very enthusiastic in learning new things. With his immense interest, he is guiding BTech and diploma students who are coming to his department for internship and industrial training every year. We welcome you, sir. Surinder sir, Surinder sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Ennachi?
Sir has he gone out, ma'am. Ask him to join back. Yes, yes.
He joined back?
No, ma'am. He has not joined back.
What happened?
He was there with us. Just now he his net got cut, it seems. He went out.
Calling sir, don't know okay. What's happening. Hello, sir.
Sir has, yes, sir has joined now, ma'am.
Sir has joined now, ma'am.
Okay, sir.
Hello.
Sir, we welcome you. Start the presentation, sir.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, good evening, one and all. I'm very happy to be with you all this evening. So, now I want to go for a screen sharing and present it.
Yes, sir. Share your screen and then you can present it, sir. Present now will be there, sir.
Is it okay now?
Yes, sir. Sir, kindly make it into full screen, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir. Kindly make it into full screen, sir.
Is it visible now?
Yeah, yes, sir. It is visible. Make it into full screen, sir. F5.
Okay, okay, right.
Okay. Right, sir.
Okay,
now you can be able to see, sir. View, sir. Thank you.
So, a very warm welcome to all the civil engineers in the group. Okay, okay. A very warm welcome to all the civil engineers in the group. So, first of all, I would like to tell about the uniqueness of civil engineering. When I was a student, one of our professors, Professor P.G. Sastri, Principal REC Warangal, he has once said, civil engineering is the mother of all engineerings. So mechanical, electrical, electronics, communication are the derivatives from civil engineering, and courses like chemical, metallurgy, computer science, mechatronics, textiles, etc. are the byproducts of and the derivatives of the other engineers, and engineering and play as application part only. We all should be proud to be civil engineers. Hope all of us should be proud to be a civil engineer. So, according to my field experience and academic experience and design experience, I have evolved certain things which a civil engineer should possess. So, a civil engineer professional, he has to be energetic. Energetic in the sense, he should be in education and enthusiastic things and explorative. So many explore all the possibilities. Objective, what is NCAP available, and you have to give the end product. And effective, we should be, it should be cost effective, and it should be whatever we release, that should be discharged, it should be effective. And it should be economic also. So I cannot go for constructing of huge structures with duly wasting public money. So which is really needed for the public, that also you have to take care and keep it in mind while designing a structure. And you have to equip yourself, and you have to entrust, and we should be efficient in our discharge. Another thing is empathetic. What is the meaning of empathy? So we need to react to the needs of the public, especially civil, being civil engineers. We should be responsible citizens of India, and we should be ready to cater the needs of the civil public. Okay. In olden days, the half-life period of engineering used to be as follows. Civil engineering is 30 years, mechanical engineering 10 years, electrical engineering 5 years, electronics and communication engineering 2 years, computer science engineering 3 months. So what I mean to say is, if I study a course that is that was applicable for 30 years in olden days, but whereas for computer professionals, every 3 months it is going to be updated. But nowadays, the half-life period of civil engineering also has come down to 6 months. So we should be always tuned to current trends of the community and the civil engineering field. So we should be thorough with model modifications, modernization in construction technology and machinery, automation techniques, latest programming languages and application softwares, communicative and soft skills, creativity, assertiveness in research and development work. And finally, artificial intelligence also plays a vital role in civil engineering development nowadays. So now it is time
Sir, excuse me, sir. The voice is not
audible. We on our toes to update. Why? Because lot of infrastructure. Not audible. Wait.
Sir, your voice is getting cut in between.
Okay. I'll just check and get back to you.
Okay.
How is it now?
Fine, sir. Carry on.
Okay. Right. So civil engineers have a greater role in development of the country. Economy is directly dependent on the transportation network. In fact, it is we who build the nation. Sometimes we are underestimated and ill-treated as second citizens, but we should be ready to prove our caliber as and when opportunity knocks our doors. Now we are going to see different structures. So a building structure requires thorough knowledge of geotechnical engineering, structural engineering, and caudal provisions of construction, municipal bylaws, etc. A road construction requires thorough knowledge of transportation engineering, geotechnical engineering, water resources engineering, structural engineering for special structures and whenever a problem arises. And communication engineering also plays a vital role in road construction nowadays, because now the trend is intelligent transport system. So everything should be automated. Your toll collection need to be automated, and your movement also will be recorded. And if something goes wrong, you will be caught up in fraction of minutes. So that's how technology is being used in road development. A dam construction requires water resource engineering, geotechnical engineering, and structural engineering. But ultimately, a bridge construction requires the conglomerate knowledge of all the fields. Basically, transportation engineering, geotechnical engineering, water resources engineering, structural engineering, geology, geography, communication engineering, public health engineering. So a bridge engineer need to have lot of knowledge in all these things. IRC also specifies specialized experienced people only should handle design, planning, and execution of bridges. So whenever some opportunity comes for us to take up any bridge work, it is better to accept as a challenge and go ahead with the work. A building is designed for a life of 50 years, but a bridge is designed for 100 years. So a very little experience in civil engineering will contribute a much for the socio-economic development of the society. Someone says, an ounce of experience worth a ton of theory. So whatever you learn, you have to keep it in practice, then only it will be worth to the public. And someone says, it's a great saying, in fact, in times of crisis, the wise men build the bridges, but the fools build the barriers. So if someone is interested in learning bridges, he is a wise man, according to this quote. So we have the greater opportunity to bridge the gaps in connectivity, whatever it may be. Now we are going to come into our actual part, that is uniqueness of a bridge. No two bridges are identical. We can see many buildings are identical and they are constructed as clusters, 100 buildings, 200 buildings like that, with the same type design. But when it comes to bridge, it is unique. Every bridge has a unique soil properties, hydrological features, geometrical diversity, etc. We usually build a building in an accessible area with all facilities available during construction. But 90% of the bridges are built in remote areas where there are meagre or no facilities at all. In fact, in the beginning of service, I had the opportunity to plan, survey, and design 5 major bridges along tributaries of Godavari in Khammam district of Andhra Pradesh. It was the United States then. 150 kilometers away from the headquarters, all alone in doing the work. Of course, there is little manpower available with me to take up survey, to carry the survey instruments and all. So that's how we can say that bridge is a unique structure, and it is to be, most of the bridges are to be remote areas. Okay, so bridge engineering is a challenging job. So today, let us concentrate on basic concepts of planning and design of bridges. So, what is a bridge? According to IRC, bridge is defined as a structure that provides passes over an obstacle without closing the way beneath. The required passageway may be a road, a railway, pedestrians, a canal, or a pipeline. The obstacle may be a river, road, railway, or a valley. So this is how we can define the bridge. So the picture shown here is a major bridge which we are taking up now in Maner of Karimnagar district. So what are the main components of a bridge? As you are all aware, and you have a lot of knowledge, and all the professors and faculty have come up here to this session. So you all must be knowing this, but however, it's a great opportunity for us to refresh ourselves. So a bridge consists of the foundation, the substructure, the superstructure. So they are the basic components. The foundation could be a raft, well, or footings, etc. The substructure is abutments and piers. The superstructure is bearing, deck slab, girder, trusses, handrails, etc. And river training works. So rivetment for slopes at abutments, aprons at bed level, and nowadays, instead of rivetment, you are going for a paneled rivetment structure. So, and approaches to bridge, this is also very much important. So to connect the bridge proper to the roads on either side, approaches are constructed. So before we proceeding, let me simply explain about the approaches here. So IRC specifies there is a minimum slope that is to be maintained, minimum gradient from bridge deck slab to the connecting road, that is 1 in 40. You need to keep it in mind. If the bridge is of a height of 5 meters, you need to have 200 meters of approaches on either side. Okay, so this is the typical drawing for a bridge. So these are the approach slabs, and this is our abutment, and this is pier. This is the deck slab with a T-beam and curbs, and we have expansion joints, handrails, parapets, and you can clearly see the HFL here and the bed level, foundation levels, etc. So classification of bridges. Can I proceed? So there are about 10 types of classification of bridges. So according to function, it is aqueduct, viaduct, pedestrian, highway, railway, rail cum road, pipeline, etc. According to material use, timber, steel, RCC, PSC, masonry, iron, composite, aluminium, and several new types of concretes have been evolved, that is self-compacting concrete, high-performance concrete, fiber-reinforced concrete, and ultra-high-performance concrete. So you may wonder whether timber is used in the bridge construction, but I have seen a bridge which is constructed by British people about 150 years back on one of the tributaries of River Godavari. It was a teakwood bridge of 30 meters span with a intermittent support. That is also a wooden support. And that lasted for 150 years. And when I was there as a field engineer, I have replaced it with the RCC bridge, keeping in view the damage that has been caused due to a flash flood in Godavari. Okay. So another type of classification is based on superstructure, slab, beam, truss, arch, and suspension. According to the interspan, simple, cantilever, and continuous. I'll show all the photographs of all these classification after explaining the classification now. So according to the position of the floor, we have deck type, through type, half through type, and suspended type. According to positioning with reference to RCL and HFL. What is RCL? It is road crest level, and HFL is highest flood level. So according to position, high level bridge and submergible bridge. Of course, low level causeways, high level causeways will all come under this second category. According to the method of construction, it is pin jointed, riveted, and welded. According to clearance for navigation, high level, movable, swing type, movable, sway type, and transported bridge. According to span, this is very important. So culvert, it is less than 8 meters. In some textbooks, they say it is less than 6 meters, but IRC specifies it is less than 8 meters. And minor bridges, it is 8 to 30 meters. Major bridges, it is more than 30 meters. Nowadays, there are long span bridges also being constructed for which the span is more than 120 meters. So according to degree of redundancy, it is determinate structure and indeterminate structure. According to anticipated service, it is a permanent and temporary. So temporary structures are basically used in border areas where pontoons, bridges are constructed for military purpose. So they will cross the road using the temporary bridge, and after the purpose is over, they will destroy it or displace it. Why? Because to avoid infiltration of miscreants from other border countries. Okay. So this is the classification. So the trend of the day also we need to know about bridges. To use most modern methods and material for construction. So several new types of concretes have been developed, which include self-compacting concrete, high-performance concrete, fiber-reinforced concrete, and ultra-high-performance concrete. So second trend is aesthetics and architectural importance. So when a bridge is constructed near to a important town or near to a important around, and you should feel proud of the structure, and it should be attractive also. So some of the aesthetic bridges I will show to you now. Another thing is environment friendly methods and modes. So that is also very much important. Fourth thing is free passes and crossing of wild and domestic animal to cross the bridge. In fact, we are encouraging their habitat.
Sir, your voice is breaking.
Hence, we should avoid human passes and training for 4 days. Now also breaking. How is it now? Hello?
Okay, sir. Now okay.
Hello?
Now okay, sir. I can proceed.
Okay, right. So, I'm telling about a training program that was conducted in February this year by the Institution of Academy of Highway Engineers, IAHE. So that is located in Delhi. There we have been trained and exposed to expressway constructions. Expressway construction means the design speed is 120 kmph. So there, for any road that is expressway, we have to construct a clear underpass at every 500 meters of the road to allow the domestic animals and wild animals to move freely. So these are some of the bridges. So this first bridge is a bridge constructed across River Godavari in Bhadrachalam. So that was constructed in 1966 by our R&B department. It is about 2 kilometers length. So the bottom bridge, that is this bridge, is a new bridge constructed across River Godavari. It's of 1.2 kilometers length. It is constructed in Yetur Nagaram of Warangal district. So it is a recent construction. So this side we have a suspension bridge. It is also located in Warangal only. Some of you might have heard about Lakkanavaram. It's a very beautiful place. So this bridge is constructed for pedestrians. Of course, this bridge is constructed 30 years back. This year only we have constructed a new bridge of 210 meters span, which can accommodate 1,000 passengers, 1,000 pedestrians at a time. So this is the new bridge which has been constructed this year. Okay. So I have told you about bowstring bridges and all. So this is a bridge across River Godavari. So this side, to my right, you can clearly see a special type of bridge. So what is its purpose? So this is the expressway. So here and both sides, left and right side, we have a deep forest, and there is every possibility for the animals and wild animals to move around. So without obstructing their movements, so a bridge is constructed is like this. Okay. So these to my right here. So nowadays, to the upstream side of the bridge, a weir is constructed like this, and this can store water, and this can be used to recharge the ground level and also for irrigation purpose. Okay. So previously I told you, no, bridge is a unique structure, and most of the bridges are constructed in remote areas. So this is one of the locations which I have surveyed, and a bridge is constructed here. So this is a Bogata waterfalls in Khammam district. Now it has come to Warangal district after state formation. And there is a Vagu named Chikupalli Vagu here. So this is the Chikupalli Vagu. So across this Vago also, a bridge is constructed recently. So now we will go deep into our discussion, that is planning of a road bridge over a canal, a river or a stream. Since I am basically a civil engineer who is dealing with road bridges and roads, so my focus will be on this for today's discussion. Okay, I'll break for 1 minute and get back to you. Okay, thank you. Planning at the beginning of project. So planning involves three things. So at the beginning of project, during the project, and after. Associate planning. At the beginning of project only, but we need to have a thorough planning till completion and even after completion. That speaks about maintenance also. Okay, so planning of site for a bridge. So this all you will be studying during your UG courses. So most of the institutes have this as their curriculum. So a straight reach of the river is desirable. So at points of meandering and at points of sharp curvature, we have to avoid selecting the site. And there should be steady river flow and narrow channel with. Hello? Is it audible?
Yes, sir. You carry on, sir. There is some disturbance, sir. Sorry.
Okay, right. So, suitable high banks above HFL on each side. So that is also is very much important. So in some places people have selected the location where outflanking is done frequently. So in those places it will be very difficult for us to plan for approaches and all. Why? Because the bridge will be intact but the approaches will be washed off. So this point D is very much important. And rock or ineradible strata close to the river bed is very much important. And economical approaches. So the approaches should be economical. And absence of sharp curves on approaches, straight alignment of the road, inexpensive river draining works, and proximity of material. So this speaks of basic planning for a bridge. And what is the data to be collected? So preliminary data, detailed investigation, and data during construction. These are the other steps. So preliminary data. So name of the river, road stretch, location of probable bridge site, location of nearest GTS benchmark and its reduced level, present and anticipated traffic, and hydraulic data, HFL, maximum water level, lowest water level, site, shape and slope of the catchment area, intensity and frequency of rainfall, probability of large trees and rolling debris. So most of the river sites, what happens is many trees will be uprooted and they will be coming floating. What happens is lot of obstruction will be of washing away of bridge. So soil profile along the probable sites. So quarries, source of material, power supply, earthquake zones. That is also you need to observe. Details of other bridges, dams, reservoirs, etc. in the vicinity? Is it important to go for investigation of the dams and reservoirs in the vicinity? Definitely. Why? Because there are major train accidents happened in Andhra Pradesh. So if you go through Google search, you can see Delta Express accident that happened in Kurnool area. So what happened is there were heavy rains overnight, and one of the dams, a small reservoir, has been breached. So the railway bridge has been washed out along with the train, and around 700 people, they passed away on a single day. So that is a fatal accident. So as a bridge engineer, we have to have details of other bridges. Details of other bridges helps us to calculate the vent way and arrive at the other structural aspects. So details of utilities. So when we construct a bridge, we need to have a coordination meeting with BSNL, Electricity Board, and Public Health Department. Why? Because their utility lines also need to be laid across our bridges. So this is very important for field engineers also. Why? Because simply designing and construction will not solve the purpose. So this also we need to have in mind. So what are the preliminary investigations and drawings to be arrived? So index map. So location of the bridge, alternative site, existing communication lines, topography of the area, important towns, industries, pilgrim centers, etc. The scale needs to be 1:50,000. So this is specified in IRC 5, 2014. You may go through that afterwards. Another thing is contour survey plan. So all topographical features have to be observed. And for catchment areas less than or equal to 3 square meters, we have to take contours for 100 meters or either side of site of crossing. For 3 to 15 square kilometers, 300 meters on either side. For more than 15 square kilometer of catchment area, 1500 meters on either side. So the scale need to be 1:500 to 1:1000. This also is specified in IRC 5. Okay. So hydrological surveys and drawings. So many have the opinion that bridges are connected with structural engineering only. So structural engineering plays only 20 to 30% of the role. Rest of the role is played by hydrological engineers and soil mechanics engineers, transportation engineers. Okay. So what are the hydrological surveys and drawings to be considered? So site plan is to be prepared for up to 200 meters on upstream and downstream. So sections need to be 100 meters, 200 meters, etc. So name of the stream, outline of the banks, direction of flow, alignment of approaches, direction of flow, and skew. What is skew? This is also very much important. Skew is nothing but the deviation from the normalcy of the road. So the alignment will be perpendicular to each other. But in most of the cases, it will not be a normal crossing. So there will be slight deviation. So that deviation is called skew. Okay. So longitudinal section and cross section of the road and stream. TPS means trial pits and boreholes, nullahs, buildings, etc. All these things to be marked in the site plan. So cross section of the river need to be done. That is, horizontal scale is 1:1000 and vertical scale is 1:100. So name of the river, road, river bed lines, HFL, nature of subsoil, LWL, tidal features in coastal areas near to beaches. So that also we need to. So LS of the river, longitudinal section is 1:1000. So HFL, OFL, LWL are suitable at suitable intervals. So catchment area of map, how to find the catchment area? Topo sheets prepared by the Geological Survey of India are available for sales. So if you approach the Geological Survey of India with the district for which you are interested in, they will sell the topo sheets. Of course, for a district there will be not less than 100 topo sheets. So you have to purchase them before proceeding for a detailed investigation. And in irrigation department and roads and buildings, that is PWD department, libraries, these are readily available. So for academic purpose and for any other purpose, you can refer to the library of your engineering college or any of the lines, etc., to be traced. So drawing the ridge lines of the adjoining tributaries. So you all must be aware of that. Okay. So ultimately what you have to do is, so you should have a close inspection of the entire bridge site. If possible, you have to walk minimum 2 to 3 kilometers on either side of the site of crossing and arrive at all these features. Okay. Then geophysical investigations for subsoil explorations. So detailed investigations. So IRC 78/2014 gives these guidelines. In fact, this is an extract from the IRC book. So IS 1892 and IS 2720 to classify the 1498 to classify the soil. So IS 1892 speaks of site investigation for foundations, and IS 2720 speaks of methods of test for soil, and IS 1498 speaks of classification of soils. So geophysical investigation plays a vital role. Why? Because there are deceptive soils beneath the designed foundation level. So that will be a major disaster if you don't investigate properly. So you must be knowing Koyna Dam. So why lot of earthquakes are induced due to Koyna Dam is because there were no proper geophysical subsurface soundings for that dam. Okay, as per clause 6.2.3 of IS 78/2014, the following tests are to be conducted: for cohesionless soils, classification tests, index properties. What are index properties? Liquid limit, plastic limit, and plasticity index, and density. So these are the lab tests, and field tests, plate load test, standard penetration test, static cone penetration test, and dynamic cone penetration test. So these are the tests to be conducted for cohesionless soils. And for cohesive soils, classification, index properties, unconfined compression test, and consolidation test. These are the lab tests. And for field tests, in addition to the 4 tests prescribed for the cohesionless soil, fifth test is vein shear test. Where slushy soils occur, you need to go for this vein shear test. So after arriving the properties and conducting all these tests, we need to prepare a borehole data and a bore log chart. Okay. So sixth point in planning before execution is choice of bridge type. So which type of bridge do we use? that is also very much important. And determination of decision research. Prepare the project report. Estimates, designs, and drawings, and preparation of the documents and Hello?
Yes, sir, we can continue, sir.
Okay, somebody is speaking English.
Yes, sir, I have muted them, sir.
Okay.
All of you kindly mute your mic, participant. Why by Surakar sir? Kindly mute.
Okay, madam. Hello.
All of you kindly mute your mic. Vishwanath Varma sir. Why by Surakar sir? Vaibhav Shirodkar sir, kindly mute your mic. Okay sir, sorry for the disturbance. Continue sir.
Okay. So previously I told of choice of bridge type. So what is the type of bridge we need to construct? There are certain guidelines here. So for a typical up to 10 meters RCC solid slabs will be constructed, and it's very detailed sheet. 15 to 20 pre-stressed concrete girders, so 20 to 30 and 40 up to 60 meters also we go for PSC girders and bowstring spans, and 70 to 100 meters balanced cantilevers, arch bridges and bowstrings, 100 to 300 meters span, arch bridges and extra dosed bridges, 300 to 600 meters cable stayed bridges, more than 600 meters suspended cable spans. So here you need to keep one thing in mind, that is as the spans increases, the cost also increases. So as far as possible, we need restrict spans. So that is very much important. Okay, now I speak of span construct. Excuse me, somebody is talking in between. Can you mute them?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So planning during construction. So project management. So marking, setting out, and beginning the work. Machinery and manpower deployment. So even professionals also need to be deployed beforehand. Usually what happens is whenever some superintending engineer or chief engineer is planned to come, then only they will deploy technical people. So that is a very sad state of affairs. So this need to be kept in mind. So achieving milestones. So there are many methods. You must be aware of CPM and PERT, critical path method, program evaluation review techniques. You must be aware of that. And there are other softwares also are available. Directly work out what nature of labor and how much quantity of labor and how much quantity of material is required on a particular date to complete the work according to schedule. If we are lagging, how much more do we need to pump in? The resources need to be pumped in. That also this software will plan. So Primavera is a very important software which all civil engineers can learn. Then quality assurance and management. So testing laboratory to be fixed at site only. There is a specification in the MORTH, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. So it says quality control lab at every bridge site to be erected invariably where the quantum value of work is more than 2 crores. So that is very much important. So monthly billing and payments. So financial inflows and outflows need to be regulated. Review meetings with project monitoring consultancy, third party quality control team and the executing agency need to be conducted periodically. So periodical meetings will be preferably monthly ones, and if any special issue and critical issues are there, it can be planned once in 15 minutes. So these are all guidelines of MORTH, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. Okay, so planning for completion and planning after completion. So this is also very much important. As-built drawings. What are as-built drawings? So during the execution and immediately after execution, all the team will prepare the drawings, how the work has been done, and the completion drawings. So as-built drawings are nothing but completion drawings. So these are to be kept in safe custody. Why? Because in case of any special event occurs, you must be wondering, if 400 tons of stone has been carried from Tamil Nadu to Hyderabad of Telangana during 1990s when I was a student. So then our REC professors were asked to investigate the suitability of the all the road bridges to carry that particular load. So it was a Herculean task for the professors. They need to coordinate with all engineering departments and they need to obtain drawings. So in the presence of these drawings, it will be very easy for the professors and specialists to analyze the structure. So if this is not there, again you have to go for back calculation, you have to go for trial pits again, and you have to assess the structure. If required, you have to expose reinforcement also, and you have to assess. So this is very much important, which is mostly neglected. So final inspection of quality control and clearance by the quality assurance team. This is also very much important. Why? Because any bridge or major structure will have a defect liability period of 2 years. Defect liability period after period, the contractor problem is not identified by the quality control team. Well, in advance, what happens is he will simply take away his money and go away, and he is not traceable. And it will be a very Herculean task for the engineering wings to take up any repairs during untoward incidents. So this is very much important. And project completion report. So this is also very much important. And project commissioning. Commissioning means we have to open it to the public in use. So these are the different things for planning. So I think these details are very much sufficient for the planning part, and there are many other issues also which you can come across. So it is the area specific problems will be there, and you have to plan accordingly. So now we will go into the design part. So design part of a bridge is basically done by hydraulic engineers as well as structural engineers. So hydraulic design is to be done by professionals from hydrology and water resource engineering. So they need to calculate design discharges, finding linear waterway, calculating cover depths, and finalizing the foundations and foundation levels. So when it comes to design of a superstructure, loads on structure as per IRC 78-2014 need to be considered. So design of abutments and piers. So stability analysis is to be done as we do in soil mechanics. So this is also very much important, and design of foundations. So raft, well foundation, open foundation, and all these things to be done. Then coming to design of aprons. So this is also very much important. So we need to design the launching aprons at upstream and downstream sites. Design of deck slab and girders, and design of bearings. So this part need to be done by the structural engineers and structural consultants. So rest of the things are done by basic things, important soil, what you call foundation, and substructure is designed by hydrology engineers and soil mechanics engineers.
Presentation is not visible.
So that is very much important. And structures need to be done by structures. What? Hello? What is not visible?
Presentation. Hello?
Not visible.
Sir, please pin.
Hello?
Sir, it is visible, sir. For somebody it is not visible. We will guide them. You carry on, sir.
Okay, right. So, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, they have given standard drawings for for the standard plans for both these things. So that is also I am going to share to you. So before going into detailed design aspect, let us first concentrate on the estimation of a bridge. So a bridge estimation has basically two components. So what are the components? It is the bridge proper and the approaches. So both need to be done separately. So specification report. So this speaks of the importance of the bridge, special features, what are the foundations adopted, what are the sections adopted, and what is the program of execution, and what is the caudal provisions, and what is the standard schedule of rates. So SSR, you must be aware of that. So that need to be incorporated in the report. So this is not, so this abstract include, this includes the financial part of the estimate. So here you will have two components. First is the actual cost of the civil work, that is bridge and approaches here, and second component is the amenities. What are the amenities? So they speak about the road safety interventions and special lighting to the bridge, and you need to have a provision for the supervision charges and all. So RMRs, RMR means road material rates. So individual components have to be evolved for the rates. And lead chart and quarry maps, these are also required. And data using MORTH standard data book. So in bridge you will come across not less than 40 to 50 items of work. So for each item you have to go for a rate analysis. So that MORTH has specified a data book, standard data book, and in the data book.
Sir, voice is breaking, sir.
So what are the different quantities of cement to be used for other? Okay. Is it audible now?
Yes, sir. Now it is audible, sir.
Okay. Maybe some connectivity issues. Okay.
Yes, thank you.
Okay. Right. Then detailed estimate. So this speaks of quantitative analysis. You all must be.
Sir, audio is not clear.
Of this, you have quantity surveying with you, so detailed estimate of abstract estimate. So this speaks about the. Okay, is it okay now? Hello. Hello. Hello.
Sir, carry on, sir.
Okay, is it audible now, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Now it is audible, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, general arrangement drawing, bridge drawings, site plan, level field book, and earthwork calculations. These are the basic things required for a which forms an estimate. So without all these components, it is not a complete estimate. Usually what happens is only some part will be xeroxed and used in the field. If one of the drawings is missing, the entire bridge project will be messed up. So these are the important things. So if you don't plan properly, what happens? So delayed project completion. So if a bridge is proposed to be constructed in 2 years, it will take 5 to 10 years if proper planning is not done at all levels, which I have told you. And escalation in project costs. So most of the bridges, they will start with 10 crores and they will end up with 60 to 70 crores. Why? Because improper planning. If you don't investigate during construction and before construction, what happens? You design for a open foundations, but you get a very slushy soil wherein you are forced to go for a well type of foundation. Sinking cost, training cost, and everything will be a very costly affair. So then the price will automatically doubles up, triples up, and it quadruples like that. So possible bridge failures. So if proper planning is not done, bridges also will fail. So it happens if proper hydrogeological surveys are not done, the bridges will be washed away. So here one important point I want to tell you, how to find out HFL, highest flood level. So for major rivers, they are all available. For other rivers, they are not available. So what to do? So that is also you need to incorporate during investigation stage. Okay, now I'll jump into hydraulic design. So calculation of design discharge. We have four methods of flood estimation. So most of you are hydraulics experts, but I am supposed to tell, I am just repeating. So empirical method, rational method, unit hydrograph method, flood frequency studies. So I have previously told now, for bridges across major rivers, hydrogeological data is available from Central Water Commission. So there is a governing body to flood forecast and manage the water resources in our country, that is Central Water Commission. So for major rivers, that data is available. For most of the bridges, so you may be wondering, 99% of other streams and tributaries, no data is available. So there we have to depend on empirical methods only. Okay, so empirical methods, there are four types of empirical methods which are generally taught. So Dickens formula, Rice formula, Fuller's formula, and okay, so when it comes to Dickens formula, we have Q, maximum flood discharge is equal to Ca to the power 3/4. So where A is the catchment area in square kilometers and C is the Dickens constant applicable in India. So the value will be 6 to 30. For North Indian plains, it is 6. For North Indian hilly regions, 11 to 14. For Central India, it is 14 to 28. For coastal Andhra and Orissa, it is 20 to 28. But when it comes to Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, and other southern parts of the country, we need to go for Rive's formula. So Rive's formula is Q is equal to Ca to the power 2/3. So it is developed, basically developed for Tamil Nadu, but now used in Karnataka and AP also. So C value is 6.8 for area located within 80 kilometers from coast and 80 to 160 kilometers from coast, it is 8.5, and 10.2 for hilly regions. So other empirical formulas like English, it is used for in AP and Telangana, we usually use Dickens formula. Why? Because this is nearer to the actual discharges that are observed. So result will be compared with actual discharge based on area velocity method obtained from cross section of stream at site of crossing at other sections upstream and downstream. All other features of hydraulic design will be explained with an example now. Okay. Okay, is it visible now? Hello?
Yes, sir, it's visible, you can proceed.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir, it's clear. Okay. Little bit zoom you have to do.
Okay. So, this particular design is for a small bridge across one of the tributaries of River Godavari. It is not a tributary, it's a fourth order stream across River Godavari. Okay, so I have previously told now, So we need to take cross sections at all intervals at site of crossing and at upstream and downstream. Okay, so this is the catchment area of the stream. So this entire sheet is a topo sheet. It is to 1:1 which we are interested. And okay, so this is our road. Road component is this one. This is the road component, and this is the stream which we are interested in surveying now. So across the stream, if you go, so these are the third order, fourth order, and second order streams here. So another stream is here, adjoining this river, and these are those tributaries. So the ridge line is drawn along the points of confluence between both the river basins, both the basins. So this is the catchment area which we have arrived. So this is around 42.5 square kilometers. Okay, is it clear? So after arriving the catchment area, then we go for the cross sections of the stream. So this is the, this is our road and this is our river. So the stream flows like this. Of course, there is a small skew here, that is 8.5 degrees here, which I have explained what is the definition of skew. So if this is the normal crossing and this is just 8 degrees away from the normal crossing, so that's why it's a small skew bridge. One more point I want to add here is, if the skew is less than 15 degrees, we have to design it as a normal crossing only. But for obstruction purpose, hydrological considerations, you need to consider it for the analysis. So this Q is considered for analysis purpose and ignored for the construction purpose. Okay. Why? Because skew gives increase in linear waterway and all. So it's safe to go for a considering the skew. So there is no problem with that. So these are certain cross sections there, which we have actually done it in the field. So first part I have told now. So the catchment area is 42.5 square kilometers, and Deakin's formula is used here, Cm to the power 3/4. C is a constant. Usually we take 12 for our Telangana basin. Okay, so based on the Deakin's formula, we have arrived a catchment area. That is, we have arrived a design discharge of 199.744 cubic meters per second. So now the important part is calculation of bed slopes. So reduced level at 280 meters upstream of the stream of the river. So the total distance is 600 meters. The slope works out to, based on the RLs of the bed level, we have arrived the slope as 0.073. So upstream slope is also arrived, that is 0.0107, and downstream slope is 0.0044. So for actual discharge, we go for the calculation of discharge by area velocity method. So this is at the site of crossing. So here HFL is given, and chain is, it starts from zero here. So 5 meters on either side, up to 25 meters this side and 25 meters this side. You can go even more than that. If it's a major river, you have to go up to more than 2 kilometers on either side, like that. Okay, so since if you know the design concepts of a small bridge, you can design any type of bridge. That's why I have taken a small bridge for explanation purpose. Okay, so here there are certain columns, chainage, HFL, ground level, and depth of flow from HFL to ground level, you can arrive, distance and mean depth, area based on the trapezoidal method, and perimeter, that is as per the cross sections drawn for all these intervals. Okay, so now we have got the hydraulic mean depth, that is mean radius r is equal to a by p, that is 1.448, and slope is all bed slope is already calculated, and the rugosity coefficient is used for the Manning's formula. You must be aware of it. Velocity is equal to 1 by n r to the power 2 by 3 and s to the power half. S is nothing but slope, and you can denote it as I also in your academic purpose. Hello? Okay. So, what is the rugosity coefficient? So, it is a factor dependent on the rugosity coefficient is a factor dependent on the particle size, particles. So, I'll give you a detailed description of it. Okay. The value of okay, so here the rugosity coefficient is taken considered is 0.035, and the discharge, actual discharge obtained is 209 cubic meters per second. Same way you have to consider a section at 280 meters upstream, and the same method follows, and it is 169 cubic meters per second. And the downstream side 320, here the discharge is 220.894. So you prepare a table like this. Summary of the discharge at 280 meters upstream, site of crossing, downstream, and the discharge here. And you have the discharge calculated based on the catchment area method also. And you have to compare. And the deviation should not be more than 10%. That is also you need to keep it in mind. If there is lot of deviation, you need to survey again. Okay. So here the design discharge considered is 209.101 cubic meters per second, and maximum flood level, sill level is 95.12, and velocity of flow, which is already calculated previously based on Manning's constant, that is 3.167, and depth of flow is here, and flux 0.15 as per IRC 5, and head due to flux, so v square d square divided by d plus x square and 2g, so v square by 2gd, so formula is used here, and the combined head is 0.612. so velocity through vents is given here, so that is 3.119 meters per second. So now the linear waterway is calculated like this. So linear waterway is discharge, design discharge by velocity into d, depth of flow. So 209.101 by 3.119 into 2.88. So this is linear waterway is 23.278. I have already told you, know the skew is somewhat 8.12 degrees. So linear waterway in skew is 23.298 multiplied by secant theta, secant 8.12, that is 23.514. So that's how you have arrived the linear waterway. So important aspect after arriving the linear waterway is to fix the vent way. So how many piers are to be constructed and how the spacing is done. So vent way is to be fixed. So here you can see the vent way of three vents of 8 meters. Why? Because the linear waterway is 23.514 and you have provided three vents of 8 meters of effective length here. So for your understanding, I'll just show a map here. So this is a bridge with three vents of 8 meters, which is drawn like this. Okay. So this is one vent, this is one vent, this is one vent. That's how you will arrive the vent way. So after arriving the vent way, you have to calculate the scour depths. What is normal scour depth? So HFL is 98 and sea level is there, and width per dB means it is discharge per unit length of the waterway. So linear waterway, that is 11.33 here, and you have DSM, so that is scour depth, 1.34 dB square by KSF square. KSF square is a silt factor. So silt factor, you need to note down.
Balaji.
Okay. So the value of hello.
Sir, carry on, sir.
Carry on, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Sir, please carry on, sir. We are audible, sir. We are audible.
The type of bedment. Okay. Here you can see the type of bedment. Material coarse silt median diameter of the weighted mean. What is weight? So how to calculate the weighted mean diameter of a particle for all the particles that are found in the bed level? So according to that, you have to calculate the DM. So that is mean diameter. So for coarse silt, is 0.04 millimeter. KSF, as I have already told you, it is silt factor. Silt factor is read from this table, 0.35 to 2.42, like this. So you have to interpolate based on the mean diameter. So okay.
Feedback link.
Okay, now, so we have considered the silt factor as 1.25 as per the table, and DSM arrived is 6.265 meters here. So that is normal scour depth, which is to be considered below highest flood level, HFL. So previously I told, okay. So that's how you have to arrive. Okay, so here you can clearly see HFL. I told you previously how to arrive the HFL for small streams. You can have a visible clear cut banks if you move around the stream, and you can inquire from old people, those who are residing there, and you can arrive that. And if required, you can take the help from irrigation and command area development people also. So for pier, the maximum scour depth is 2 times the normal scour depth calculated. So here 6.265. So pier's maximum cover depth is 12.53 and grip length is 4.77. So maximum cover depth including grip length is 16.707. So what is for the grip length means the soil, the foundation needs to be embedded in the soil. Okay, so how, that's how you can arrive the foundation level, HFL minus maximum cover depth including grip length for the pier. So this is 81.25. So depth below sea level is 13.87 and abutment part maximum cover depth is 1.27 DSM. So there is a change here. For pier it is 2 DSM and for abutment is 1.27 DSM and all other calculation remains same. So after finalizing this, you will fix the road crust level. So that is also important. Maximum flood level plus vertical clearance from IRC code, FLEX from IRC code and deck slab thickness. So this gives the bottom of deck. So bottom of deck level plus deck thickness plus varying coat of 0.1. Overall it gives 99.90. So this is the road crust level. So after finalizing this, you will get the salient features of the bridge like this. And it is to be tabulated and hydraulic part and geotechnical part is over as of now. And coming to structural component, it's very easy. So you need not worry about that. So design of deck slabs, live load bending moment using Picard's curves, and design of cantilevers, and design of girders using Corbons. Henry Jaguar's method, Morris Little method, and design of well steening. These are two options will be arrived using design softwares. As there are specific codes from, and have a code from IRC, so that I will show here. So you have for the design of deck slab and girders, MORTH has developed and communicated DD and SD drawings. So standard plans for highway bridges, concrete slab bridges. So here you can have structural designs and drawings. For structural drawings for RCC slab bridges, 3.37 to 10.37 meter span, and for RCC skew type 15 to 60 degrees, 4.37 to 10.37 meters. And for standard plans for highway bridges, concrete slab bridges, you have SS skew bridges, T-beam bridges, RCC box cell bridges, railings, bearing coat and expansion joints. All these details are available in this standard plans for highway bridges released by the MORTH. You can readily refer them, and if you require, you can refer to your college library, or you can approach any superintending engineer of public works department who are available to you. So these are some of the bridges which are in progress now. This is the cable stayed bridge in Karimnagar. It's in brisk progress now. So this is the site map. And this is the site of crossing. So these are the features, and this is the general elevation. So these are the construction photos, and this is the girders going on, cell girders, and this is the tandems that are being pulled and inserted for the bridge. Okay, I think if any doubts, I'll be available to you. Now over to the organizers. I thank the management of Ishwari Engineering, SRM Engineering College, HOD Madam, and the coordinator Chandra Madam for giving me this opportunity. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your valuable information. Actually, maybe we have to conduct 7 days FDP. That much valuable information you are giving. 1.5 hours is not exactly enough for your lecture, sir. Really, it is very elaborate and informative. So due to time constraint, maybe with this we have to stop here, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Any questions you can
Hello.
Post it here, sir. Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Can we ask questions, sir?
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Sir, good afternoon, sir. I'm Shri.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yeah, yeah. Sir, the concrete used for the bridge construction, sir. Can you explain it, sir?
What, ma'am?
Concrete used for the bridges.
Okay, right. Madam, I told you about self-compacting concrete. Hello?
Yes, sir. Please proceed, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I'm in.
Hello.
Okay, ma'am. So there are different types of concretes that are used for bridge construction. For example, M30 grade for approach slabs and M25 grade for deck slabs. Even now, M35 and M40 are used. And special concretes are self-compacting concrete, high-performance concrete, and fiber-reinforced concrete, and ultra high performance concrete, which are used in developed countries nowadays, ma'am. Hello?
Yes, sir.
So we have one more question. Thank you.
Okay.
So we have one more question, sir.
Okay.
So for curved segment cable straight bridges, what is the design criteria for maximum twisting moment? How to find it, sir? For curved segment cable straight bridges, what is the design criteria for calculating the maximum twisting moment?
Okay. In fact, I'm not into that particular design subject. So I'll get back to you to your mail. Okay.
Hello, sir.
Okay,
sir.
Hello.
Hello, sir. I am Vidya Priya, faculty of civil department. Sir, do you hear me?
Yeah.
Sir, scour occurs at near the bend of the bridges in the river, sir. And what is the size of the grain particles which get deposited during scouring?
Okay. So usually, as per field observation, they vary from 0.2 to 2 millimeters, ma'am.
Okay, sir.
Okay, ma'am.
Sir, monsoon or dry season or post monsoon, when the scour occurs, sir?
Definitely during rainy season.
Okay, sir. So when we need to take the field samples?
Madam, there is no hard and fast rule as of now.
Okay.
But if it is in dry season, that will be very convenient for us to take cross sections at close intervals.
Okay, so what is the interval that we have to maintain? 100 meter intervals or 200, sir?
No, madam, it is clearly specified in the code. So,
okay.
100 meters, for each 100 meters, you have to obtain cross section as per the code.
Okay, sir.
There is abrupt change in alignment. Okay. So at okay. point of abrupt change also you need to madam
so what are the, okay madam. What are the okay sir what are the factors influencing scour sir
madam definitely the velocity of flow
okay
and the weight of the particle
okay sir
and the obstruction also
obstruction to flow okay sir yeah. that do you mean the sediment particles
yes. suspended sediment. Yes. Whenever the velocities are minimum, then okay. scour will happen, madam. Madam, okay. another thing is the question previously asked by you. I just want to add to it.
Yes, sir.
So regarding a survey of a bridge, usually it will not be taken just once. So there are investigation divisions. In the department, so they okay, will sir. They will take up surveys for more than 2 years. If okay, it is sir. A major bridge, if it is a okay, small sir. Bridge, hardly 1 or 2 days, that is enough. Okay, madam.
So, what time interval of data we require to analyze the scouring, sir? Like historical data we require, and even the present and future data we need to consider, sir.
Yes, madam. Both need to be considered, madam.
Okay, thank you for your explanation, sir.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay,
sir. Right.
Sir, good evening, sir.
Good evening.
It was a very good session. Actually, it was some eye-opening session, sir, about bridges. You gave us very detailed explanation right from the scratch to the top-notch design, sir. It was a very good session. Thank you. It will be very viable if you could share your contact details, preferably your mail ID for future communications.
Okay, sir. Thank you. So, can I share my? Of course, mail ID is available with Mr. Surendra now.
Okay.
And my mobile number is 9849031261.
Sir, once more, sir. 98490.
3126. Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
It was a very informative session. Thank you for the very wonderful session. So I'm basically from Karnataka.
Okay.
So my the session was very good and the PPT was very good. But at the end, we couldn't be cope up with your design problem. But somewhat we have catched it. And you explained about the scale factor in from the 1:500 to 1:1,000. So is it specified in any code book?
Okay. Yes, sir. It is situated. IRC 78, sir.
It is IRC 78 2000, sir.
2014.
IRC 78 2014.
Yeah, yeah. In IRC 78 2000 and 2014, there are lot of revisions.
Revisions. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, how many code books are there for this design of bridges generally?
Okay. In fact, I have a big list of it. I will share it to
Surendra, sir.
Surendra. Okay.
Okay, sir.
I will share all my PPT also to Surendra so that you may go through them.
Yeah, that's fine, sir. That's thanks so much.
Okay.
Yes, sir. It was a very good informative session, sir. We learned a lot from your session, sir.
Okay.
Any more questions, sir? Participants, any more questions?
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir. We can hear you, sir. Tell me, sir.
Hello, sir. Sir, good evening, sir. It's a nice session. Actually, I have one common doubt. in hilly area, there will be a frequent landslides and there will be a sharp hairpin bends. So in that situation, how you are constructing the bridges, sir? What are the remedies and challenges you are facing?
Okay, okay. So regarding hilly areas, in my lecture, I told very clearly, we have to have a clear idea of the entire terrain of the bridge site. So when it comes to landslides and other disasters that are possible in the vicinity, we need to have a special structures like what you call retaining structures, and we have to stabilize all the slopes in and around the bridge structure. Why? Because if something happens, it will definitely make a negative impact on the bridge. I'll go through the literature, sir, and get back to you. Okay. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
Sir, can you again tell me your mobile number, please? 98.
Sir, I have posted in the chat box, sir.
Okay, okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, thank you so much, sir. Thank you very much for sparing a lot of time.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you. Welcome. Welcome, so, sir.
Convey my thanks to your HOD, ma'am, also. She is busy.
Sure, sir. Maybe ma'am is in meeting still.
Okay.
So she couldn't join.
Okay. Okay. Right, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you,
okay,
sir. Thank you for thank your you. Representation, sir. Thank you for a valuable time, sir.
Okay. You, sir. Actually, bridge engineering is a 180 hours of
Yes, sir. That's what I am telling. No, actually, your lecture is not enough for 1.5 hours. We need 7 days FDP for this bridge engineering alone. Maybe next time we will arrange that definitely.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Thanks to all participants and organizers also for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Tomorrow is there any sessions is there?
Yes, sir. We have one more session tomorrow on morning.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, if you don't mind, please share that session links in this command pack, sir. It will be very useful for us, sir. Yes, sir.
I will send you the. I will share the registration details for that program also here.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Please. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Actually, this section is really very useful, sir. That's why we are asking.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
Leave the meeting.
Samuel, sir.
Okay.
Sir, is it possible to take one design from your PWD end and if you can explain completely? One session, it would be great, fine for us actually to understand better where practical exposure.
Okay, definitely.
So we also want to organize one workshop from Karnataka. So if you are free enough for any next week, so that we'll ask you to give one session, sir.
Okay, okay. Right, sir.
Thank you, sir.
From which college are you?
Sir, I am from Nitya Meenakshi Institute of Technology, Bangalore.
Okay, okay.
So, I want to organize a workshop to my students. So, they are interested. So, that if you can give a session, it will be good.
Okay.
Thank you. Surinder, sir, thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Sir, you can follow us on our Insta. In there, yes, also, sir. We have all the details we have uploaded in our Instagram account and in Facebook, and as well as in our college website. You can take the link details, everything from there also, sir.
Okay, sir.
I'll post you the Insta details here, sir.
Sir, you said you have tomorrow's session. Can I just share the link?
Yes, sir. You can. Sir, I have shared you the Insta details, sir. You can there are that link. Everything is visible. Directly, you can register. You need not go and click there, and you can register, sir.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you so much.
All our programs have been available in this Insta and Facebook accounts.
Oh, okay, sir.